Hello again, and here is not another Star Wars review. Here's a response to Luette184's Getting to Know a Star Wars Fan. I've been nominated by himself, and so has my mate Steve, SithLord229. So here goes. He sets us a series of questions that will try and give you an insight into what we're like. Probably all nutters and loonies, but there you go. Right, question one. How long have you been a Star Wars fan? Well, that's very easy to answer. As long as there has been Star Wars, to be honest. Which leads me into question two. What is your earliest memory of Star Wars? Well, my earliest memory of Star Wars is actually seeing it in May in 1977. I remember queuing up for 2.5 hours because the queue was over 2 miles long at the Chelmsford Cinema. I remember going into the cinema, everyone was sitting down, there was a real buzz in the audience. Obviously, there'd been nothing like this movie ever. I'd heard things, I'd seen the novelisation, but it was not the same as sitting there, and of course, everybody's talking, and all of a sudden, there's hush, and then the Star Wars logo just hit you, and it pulled back, and the whole cinema went absolutely nuts. There was whooping, screaming, shouting, and at the end of the film, there was people just held their breath when the Star Destroyer came, and then at the end of the film, everyone was on their feet. Yelling, screaming, shouting, applauding, absolutely mental. I'm just glad to have been part of that because it was fantastic. And that is probably my earliest thing, memory of Star Wars. And it's probably the clearest memory I've got that age. And it's never left me. Absolutely blew me away. And that's why I've been a Star Wars fan ever since 1977. Question three. Who is your favourite Star Wars character of all time and why? I'm a bit unusual. I don't tend to go for the A-list characters like Lando, Han, Luke, Leia. My favourite character would probably be Wedge Antilles. Purely because I love the B characters. I think they add the depth to the Star Wars universe. That the A characters are there, they're great, they're fantastic. But they don't add as much depth as the B characters, and if you're a fan of the Star Wars X-Wing novels, then you'll understand why Wedge is one of my favourite characters of all time. And that is why, because he's not a Jedi, he's just a damn good pilot, you know, he's just very, very good, and the squadron he builds around him. The other characters, they're just, you know, I would then pick Tycho, or Jansen, or Hobby, because, you know, they are what makes the meat and bones of the Star Wars universe, and that does it for me. Question four. What is my most favourite and prized Star Wars possession and why? They're actually two different things. I would say my favourite Star Wars piece at the moment is my green helmet, my mini-scaled green helmet. I just love the detail on it. My most prized possessions are my customs, both my Astromech collection and my custom gunships. I've got a scratch-built custom E-Wing that was built by someone and I bought it off eBay. It was fantastic. It takes three-quarter-inch figures. It's just job-smacking. But my Astromech collection is probably my most prized possession. And my customs come in there a very, very close second because the amount of time and effort and research I do into making them, you know, I really enjoy them. And they're unique. They're mine. There's no one else who has any like them. They're probably my most prized possessions. But my favourite is my grey helmet, just purely because of the amount of detail involved in it. Right, question five. Where in the world do I come from? Well, I live in a small town, not tiny town, but a small town on the coast of Essex in England. The world. The universe. This dimension. Right, question six. What do I do outside my life with Star Wars? Well, as most people know, I have a wife and three kids, so I don't exactly have a lot of time. I like playing Warhammer, well, when I get a chance. I like painting and collecting Warhammer. This is where the custom droids come in. This is where I get pick up my skills to custom these droids. It's a good thing to do if you want to custom figures because it gives you fantastic groundwork and great skills to pick up. So yeah, I like a bit of Warhammer. I like watching videos, DVDs, chilling, talking to my mates on Skype, taking the mick out of Gold Leader 1, and Dean, the S-Glider 504, those two, they keep me endlessly entertained. That's about it really, you know, just like chilling, watching, doing, playing PC games. I love playing games like Company of Heroes and Dawn of War, obviously. And that's about it really, playing Rogue Leader on GameCube. Takes a lot of my time, that does. Alright, okay. 7. What is the origin of my screen name? Rasputin 37. Well, I'm afraid to say, it's not all that, it's a bit humdrum. I was trying to get a screen name that would be available. Everything I tried didn't come up available, and I just happened to be watching a documentary on the Russian Revolution at the time, and I thought, ah, Rasputin. And 37 is the age I was when I joined YouTube. So, nothing fantastic, I'm afraid. It's a bit humdrum, that one. Question 8. Apart from my videos, who else do I enjoy watching? Well, that goes without saying, I love watching Steve, SithLord229. As you might guess, there's a strong connection between our channels. I also enjoy watching Dave, Gold Leader 1s, Dean's, Lucas, Scourge Destroyer, S-Glider 504. Whatever videos I come across that are really struck me. I loved the lightsaber battle videos like RVD2, there's Contract of Evil, this is 3 in the morning, 6 in the evening, they're just fantastic films. And the fact that they're fan-made blows me away. Right, question 9. Which is the one Star Wars thing you want that you'd never probably be able to get? Well, two things. The BMF, which you've got two hopes of buying, Bob Hope, No Hope, and a full suit of Stormtrooper armour, tailored Stormtrooper armour. I'd love that, but same deal again, just never be able to afford it. Right, question 10. If I could be any Star Wars character in the universe, Star Wars universe, Corran Horn, the Rogue Squadron pilot come Jedi. Two reasons, well, three reasons actually. One, he's a Jedi, so I get to slice up Stormies with a lightsaber. Two, he's a hotshot X-Wing pilot, and I get to vape ties. It would be brilliant. And he has a rather kick-ass little companion called, little R2 Astromech called Whistler, who's even better than R2 in my estimations. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed giving you an insight into me, and I've not scared all my subscribers off. Take care, and I'll see you soon. Ta-da.